guys, welcome to Pizza Tips Pro. This is Sri Jawa here, and in today's video we gonna see how to create a WordPress website using Hostinger. So before getting into the video, if you guys haven't yet subscribed to the Pizza Tips Pro, please do subscribe. And now let's get into the video. So in this video I'll show you how can you easily create your own website in a few simple steps. So the best part is you don't need any coding experience or any huge investments. So without any delay, let's start this. Here we go. So firstly, for the website we need a hosting service provider. So we'll go over the hostinger.in. So here when you land on to the hostinger.in, you can scroll down to see the web hosting plans. So you have different plans. You can choose the plan which suits you best. So I'll go with the premium web hosting plan. So just click on add to cart, and then once you click on this, you'll be able to see this interface that shows you the order summary. So you can see here you'll get SSL certificate activation for absolutely no cost, and then here you're eligible for your free domain. So you can register for your domain here, or else you'll have an option in the further video also. So after checking these all, you can click on the checkout now. And then here you need to sign up to your Hostinger account. You can choose your email and password, your name, and then you can create your account and you can check out by paying this amount. And then once you are done with this checking out process, you can get back to this Hostinger.in, and then here in the right top corner you can see this login button. Click on the login, and here you can enter your email and password which you have used just now in the time of payment and all. So you can give your email address and password and log into this Hostinger account. So once you have logged into your Hostinger account, you can see this kind of interface, so which shows start setup. So you can click on the setup, and then you can see start now. Click on start now, and here you can claim a free domain. So to get a free domain, you need to just click on the select and click on the start now. And you can see in the below you need to enter your domain name, and you need to go for the extension .com. I recommend you to go for the .com because it's a most used one and most preferable one. So you can give your domain name and you can choose your extension and click on the search, and then you will be asking you want to build a new website or you want to migrate your website. So click select for building a new website, and then so afterwards you need to select your platform. So then we select the WordPress which is most used, and we are going to discuss about the WordPress website in this video. So we are going with the platform WordPress which is most handy. So select WordPress. After selecting the WordPress, you will get this email address and password options. So you just need to give your email address and your password, and you can just need to click on continue. And then here you can see some of the templates that you can use that might be used for you for your website construction process. So here you can choose any templates from this. You can click on show more to view more templates. So once if you want to choose any template, you have when you hover onto them, you get select and preview options. If you want to have a preview of it, you can just click on the preview and can see how does this look like. And then if you want to select it, you can just click on the select. And once you are done with this, so you can click on setting up. So after this, our setup is complete and the website is ready. Before we go into the WordPress, let's go and install the SSL certificate. So to install this SSL, we need to go to this control panel and manage site, and then here you can see this a caution mark that shows that domain is not registered yet. So in order to finish your domain registration, click on the finish domain registration, and then you need to enter your details like first name, last name, your address, your city, state and postal code, etc., your phone number, and then your domain name will be registered. And then you can see that your domain is active now. And now you go back to the dashboard, you just scroll down until you see this SSL. So once you see the SSL, select it, and then you can see this setup button. So click on the setup button and click on activate and click on install. So now your SSL is successfully installed, and now if it failed, so if it isn't registered, this might be because the domain name which you have just registered isn't completely registered yet. So you can wait for some time, like you can wait for around 1 to 2 hours, and you can retry this process. Then you will surely have no issues with this registration of installing your SSL. So this is how our website looks like. We have just chosen our template, and then now this is how it looks like. It is good, but it has lots of demo content, so we need to change it according to our website content and all. So in order to customize this, we firstly need to log into our WordPress dashboard. So firstly, we need to go to the URL, and there we need to type /vp-admin. So then once you do that, you will land on to this kind of page. So here you can give your email address and your password, and you can log in. So then this is how your WordPress dashboard look like. So you can just click on the visit site. So once you click on the visit site, so here you can see in the top navigation we have 5 different items. So we can delete or rename these items. So in order to do this, go back to the dashboard, and in the pages you can select all pages. So here you can find these pages and all pages, and then here you can find all the pages which are all inbuilt in this template. So here you can click on this quick edit, and then you can edit your menu item, or else if you want to remove any item, you can just click on this trash button, which you can see here. You can just click on the trash button, and you can just eliminate this item. And then if you want to add any more pages, you just need to go to this add new, click on this add new, and once you click on the add new, you'll just get this kind of interface. Here you need to enter your title. Once you enter the title, I want to create my blog page. So once I enter this blog in the title, and then we just need to publish this. So once you do this, our blog has been added to the pages. So you can see it over here, it has been added. So then we need to set the blog page as our blog post page for our website. In order to do this, we need to go to the settings, which is left in this left corner, and now we need to go to the reading part. So just click on the reading, and here you can see our home page is set to the home page which we have created, and we have named it as home. So our home page is set to this home page, and then our post page will be our blog page. So you just need to drop down this box, and you just need to select it to the blog. And then the another most important setting is permalinks. Just go to this permalinks, click on the permalinks, and make sure you set your set this selected to the post name, so that your URL will be simple and it will be useful for your SEO purposes. And then now another important setting is go to the appearances and go to the menus, and here we can see that this publications is in the red color because we have deleted this page. So in order to delete this from the menu, just drop down, and here you can remove this publications page. And then we want to add our blog page, so go to the view all, and here you can select the blog, and then click on the add to menu, and then here you can see our blog will be added. So don't forget to click on the save menus. So whatever change you do, don't forget to give this save, click on the button save. And then here you can get back to our website, and you can see blog is being added, and some of the items have been deleted which we have just done now. And then you go to the blog page, and here you can see this is how it looks like, because we haven't added any blog posts yet, so it looks like this. And now we'll go ahead and we'll add some blog posts in the further videos. So firstly, we just need to customize this page. So for this, we just need to click on the customize option, which we can see here in the top section. So click on the customize, And then when you click on the customize, so firstly we are going to customize our logo. So firstly, to do this, we just need to go hover onto this and just click on this pencil icon, which you can see, click on it, and here you can see like this. So click on the change logo, and then here you can see a multiple pictures that I have uploaded in the media library. Or else, if you don't have this media library pictures, you can go upload your files from your PC. And then after selecting the image, you can just click OK, and then here you can see your logo is being changed. And even you can resize this logo by changing this. You can just resize this logo too. And then now, in order to change much more customize this page, we just need to go to this option, edit with Elementor, because all of the themes and templates are built with the Elementor. So we can edit this with the Elementor. And once you click on edit with the Elementor, you can see this page. And here, in order to change the background image of this, you just need to hover onto this and click on this part. And then you can go to the style, click on the style, and then you can find this set of pictures which you have already uploaded, and then click on insert media. So then the picture of the background will be changed. And then you can even change the text by just clicking on this, and here you can change the text, or just here you can type this by clicking on this. And then I changed my text. And now you can see, if you want to delete any block, you can just hover onto this and you can click on this cross mark or this close mark in order to remove the block. And then once you are all done, you can make many changes as possible by exploring all the features here. And after this, you just click on the update. And after it is been updated, you just need to go to this three lines. So once you click on the three lines, you can see this, and you just click on view page. So then this is how your page will look like after making changes of the pictures, text and all. And then now we will see, as I have said, you have to create a blog post. We'll see now. So in the, we'll get back to this WordPress dashboard again, and then here you will see, we'll see post section in the left column here. So then click on the post, and now we need to add the categories. So here we have one uncategorized category also. So in order to add new category, we can just give our name and description and all, and click on add new category. And even we can remove some categories also. So then we have now added our category, and then now we will go to adding a new post. So now when we start with adding a new post by clicking, we need to give here our title, and then we need to give all the content of our post. So now I have quickly added the content and title to our blog post. So then you can see this plus icon over here. By using this, you can even add more elements to your blog post, like you can give your pictures and quotes, your audio and your headings and many more. And then once you are done, here in the right column, go to the document, and then here choose the WordPress, because these are the categories that we have created. So you can even add more categories and you can give them. So here I want to add it to the category WordPress. And then we need to give our featured image. So click on the featured image, and you can select one of the images. So then after choosing the image, you can insert this media like this. So here I have added my image, and then click on the publish. And after publishing, you can view your post by clicking on the view post. And then this is how your blog post will look. So this is all for this video, guys. I hope you found this video useful to you, and don't forget to subscribe to PC Tips Pro.